Hi world. As you all know, we're in the middle of this COVID-19 coronavirus pandemic. And what do you know? There is a shortage of these masks. So normally on this channel, I just make origami videos, but duty calls. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to make 6 easy DIY emergency face masks from common materials. Now remember, these are emergency face masks, so they'll hopefully help protect you in a pinch, but they're not gonna be as effective as these N95 masks. But hopefully at least they'll be better than no mask, or your elbow, or your hand. So ready, set, here goes. Number 1, the napkin, tissue, or cloth face mask. For this one, you'll need some napkins, tissues, pieces of cloth, or other foldable filters cut square, and some rubber bands, and optional, a paperclip. First step, spread out as many napkins, tissues, or pieces of cloth as you think will protect you. Keep in mind, more layers might protect you more, but will also be harder to breathe through. 5 layers, this'll protect me. I can't breathe. 1 or 2 layers is plenty. And if you're using paper napkins, in addition to lining them up perfectly, if there's a perforation in the napkin, make sure that it's horizontal. Now, lining the layers up, hold the bottom edges up and up again, twice as much, like this. Now fold the flap back down, lining up with the bottom edge, like this, and flatten. Now fold both layers up and back down and flatten. And continue until you have a paper fan. Now wrap the rubber band around and stick one end into the loop and pull. Press the rubber band together like this and tighten it by pulling it around like this, being careful not to break it. Now let go and it should stay. If it doesn't stay and you can't figure this stuff out, you could also just staple it on. And repeat that all on the other side. And now just spread out the fan and shape it like a face mask, like a bowl. You could just wrap the rubber bands around your ears, like this. But I find the mask more comfortable if you lengthen the bands like this, so you can tie it behind your neck. Like you're tying your shoes, but then put one end into the loop of the other, and pull to make the knot. Now to prevent air from slipping out the sides of your nose, that's where the paperclip comes to the rescue. Holding it here and here, slide apart and pull it open, like this. Now straighten the big end, and try to reform it so that it matches the other side. Now curve the two ends toward each other like this, so that it will fit perfectly over your nose like this. Now if you find the paperclip is falling off your nose, you can either try to push it together like this so that it's a tighter squeeze, or you can also bend these ends out more so that it grabs on, it hooks onto the mask and stays on. Just experiment to see how it stays on the best. Ta-da! And you are ready for a night out on the town. Yeah! Oops, I mean, ready to go out shopping for food and essential items. Number 2, the coffee filter mask. For this one, you'll need a coffee filter, 3 paper clips, and some rubber bands. Step 1, open the coffee filter and put it over your mouth like this. And you're done! But if you want to still use your hands, then fold the left and right sides in like this. Next, slide the paper clip on like this and insert the end of the paper clip into the pocket and pull, gently. We don't want it to poke through the coffee filter. And repeat on the other side. Now attach the rubber bands like this. Now even like this, you can use it as a mask by looping the rubber bands around your ears. And what do you know, it just happened to turn into an origami bird beak. That was totally by accident. Squawk, squawk! But again, I think it might be more comfortable if we add more rubber bands like we did in number 1 and tie them together like this. So it's a band. So you end up with a headband that goes behind your neck. Dr. Coffee, ready for surgery. Number 3, the bandana. Materials, just a bandana or a square of cloth that is big enough to easily fit around your head. Step 1, fold diagonally in half. Step 2, fold the edge up and fold it up again. Now, holding it so that the rolled material touches your face, wrap it around your head like this and tie the two ends together. Notice that the rolled material catches on your nose, preventing the face mask from slipping down. That's why we made the roll. And it also helps keep bad stuff from entering the holes on the sides of the nose. This bottom part can simply be tucked into your shirt or folded over and tucked inside, like this. And you're ready to hop on a horse and wrangle some cattle.
Yeehaw!
Number four, the clean sock.
Trust me, you really do want it clean.
For this one, you just need a sock and a rubber band. Wrap the sock around your head and attach the two ends with the rubber band. If the sock isn't long enough, then attach the two ends with more rubber bands, like we did in number one. And it can also double as a blindfold.
Where is that donkey anyway?
Number five, the toilet paper face mask.
Because if you need a mask and you have nothing but a roll of toilet paper, then quick sell it on the black market and you'll get rich. But first, pull out two full arms lengths, like this and like this. And now sell it on the black market.
Fold the end of the toilet paper over several times along the lines of the toilet paper. Now place the rolled layers over your mouth like this and wrap the rest of it around your neck gently so you don't tear it. Now narrow it and wrap it across your right nostril, over the top of your ear, behind your head, over the top of your other ear, and across your left nostril, and then wrap the rest around your neck and chin, and carefully tuck in the end. And you are ready to go out and show the world your uncanny resourcefulness. Number six, the designer t-shirt face mask.
First step, pull the shirt over your nose
and twist the back where the tag is until it becomes tight across your face. Now tuck the twisted end underneath so it's clamped between your neck and the shirt, and let go and it should stay in place. And I sure hope you showered, because you will become intimately acquainted with any body odor. And for a little extra protection, if you have a tissue, you can stick it up the inside of your shirt and over your nose and nostrils. And I sincerely hope it's a clean tissue, because you'll be smelling it otherwise.
So as you can see, I had a little fun making this video. Hopefully you guys giggled a little bit. But in all seriousness, I sincerely hope we can soon all get access to professional face masks and all get tested so we know if we're sick or not. And meanwhile, just take the necessary precautions like social distancing and quarantining. And hopefully we can beat this thing together. Well, 6 feet apart. So I hope you guys all stay safe and good luck to all of you. Bye.
Now, where is that donkey?
Oops.
And it comes off really easily, and then you can reuse it for its original purpose.